Okay, hello folks. Thanks for all your nice reactions on the forum. We really enjoyed that. We saw the example of the flea dog and the highway, which were really nice to see. And perhaps we can use them in next MOOCs because they were really nice. Especially your do-it-yourself were really excellent. And we are happy that, to see that you are so actively on the forum at this moment. But we saw also that some of you had a few problems. Especially the difference between mass balances and component balances and mass balance and concentration. Well, let's first start with the example of concentration. Well, we take a little bit of lemonade here and we put in each beaker a little bit of lemonade. So we have now two beakers, and in each beaker we have the same mass at the same concentration. So this is a typical example of a mass balance we give you. This beaker is put in the other one, and you see the total mass is doubled, but the concentration is the same. So we don't have concentration balances, but we have mass balances. Another problem was the difference between the total balance and a component balance. Well, hopefully I can illustrate this with some magnets here. I put 5 magnets in this beaker. So the concentration of the yellow magnets is now 100%, and we have a mass of 5 magnets. Now I take out 2 of them and I put 2 blue ones in it. So the total mass is still the same, but the concentration is completely different from the yellow ones, because we have only 3 out of 5 are now yellow and 2 out of 5 are blue. So you see, the total mass balance just tells you how much is entering this beaker and how much leaves this beaker. But the concentration could be quite different. We could have a different inflow and a different outflow of concentration. If we sum up the blue ones and the yellow ones in the entrance and in the exit, then we have the total mass balance. Okay, thanks. These were a few remarks on things we saw and difficulties you have with exercises. Well, we are now, the next week, we are going to deal with energy balances. And energy balances are really nice, because we saw already in the do-it-yourself one nice example of the heat balance of somebody's apartment. But that's a really nice example of a thermal energy balance. In this coming period, you will see that thermal balances are a part of the total energy balance. And hopefully you will enjoy it, and we go on with balances. Well, success, and to the next time. Okay.